Hello everyone, today we begin with the physiology of gastrointestinal tract, and in this video we are going to cover the saliva and the salivary glands. The salivary glands. There are three paired salivary glands which are made up of ducts and acini that make between 1 to 1.5 liters per day of the saliva with a pH of 6 to 7. So it is made up of ducts and acini, and it is releasing the 1 to 1.5 liters per day of the saliva with the pH of 6 to 7. There are three salivary glands: parotid gland, submandibular gland and sublingual gland. Parotid gland secretions are mostly serous and watery in nature. Submandibular secretions are serous and mucous in nature, where sublingual gland secretions are majorly mucous in nature. There are three pairs of salivary glands, which having the parotid glands, submandibular glands and sublingual glands. Now the composition of saliva. Mostly water, 99.5%. Ionic content, it is low in sodium and chloride, high in potassium and bicarbonate. Enzymes having the lingual lipase and alpha amylase, which is also known as tylin, mucins, lysozymes, which includes the proteolytic enzymes, and immunoglobulin A, which is also known as IgA. Mechanism of formation of saliva. There are two phases in the mechanism of formation of saliva. First one, primary secretion of saliva, and second one, modification of the saliva. Here in this photograph you are seeing the salivary gland. These all are the acinar cells and all these are the ductal cells, which forms the ducts of salivary gland. So primary secretion of saliva, the first phase, the acinar cells of the salivary gland secrete the initial saliva into the salivary ducts. So these acinar cells secrete saliva into the salivary ducts and acinar lumen. So this is one is the acinar lumen and it is the salivary duct. So first these acinar cells secrete the saliva into the lumen of the acini, and later it is going towards the duct of the salivary glands. Initial saliva is isotonic, which means that has the same sodium and chloride, potassium and bicarbonate concentration as that of the plasma. So isotonic saliva means the concentration of sodium, chloride, potassium and bicarbonate is almost same to that of the plasma. Now in the second phase, there will be the modification of the saliva occurs. That means that the composition of all these substances will change. So here the reabsorption of sodium and chloride occurs in the ductal cell. So here there is a reabsorption of sodium and chloride occurs in the ductal cell. So here the reabsorption of sodium and chloride occurs in the ductal cells. And secretion of potassium and bicarbonate is caused by the ductal cell. So there will be the secretion of potassium and bicarbonate inside the lumen of the duct. So there are two phases in the mechanism of formation of saliva. First one, it is the primary secretion of saliva, and second one, modification of saliva. So here at the end, whatever the saliva is formed, having the low sodium and chloride composition and high potassium and bicarbonate composition, which is hypotonic in nature. Now the functions of saliva. First of all, digestive functions. Amylase or salivary amylase, which breaks down starch, and lingual lipase break down triglycerides. But here the important thing is lingual lipase act only in the stomach, it having no action in the mouth. It dissolves food material so it can be sensed by the taste buds. Saliva dissolves the food material so it can be easily be sensed by the taste bud and we actually feel the taste of the food. So here the two enzymes, salivary amylase and lingual lipase. Salivary amylase breaks down starch and lingual lipase breaks down triglycerides, but lingual lipase only active in the stomach. Second one, lubrication. It keeps the mouth moist and thus facilitate movement of the lips and tongues during the speech. It moistens food and thus facilitates swallowing. So these both are the lubricative function of the saliva. Now the protection. Keeps mouth and teeth clean by dissolving and washing food particles from between the teeth. So it dissolves the food particles, simultaneously removes the food particles which already stick to the teeth. It has an antibacterial action. It buffers acidic gastric secretions. It buffers acidic gastric secretions. So all these are the functions of the saliva and it is the most important viva question. Now the regulation of salivary secretion. Simple or unconditioned reflex and second one conditioned reflex. So first of all we are going through the simple or unconditioned reflex. The presence of food in the mouth results in reflex secretion of the saliva. It's an obvious thing that whenever we put some food particle inside the mouth, there will be the secretion of saliva. Stimulus, presence of food in the mouth, it will be the stimulus for the initiation of simple or unconditioned reflex. Receptors, these are the taste buds. Afferent, nerves from taste buds carry impulses to salivary centers via 9th cranial nerve, which is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Center, salivary central in medulla oblongata, which is located in the brain stem. Efferent, autonomic nerve supplying the salivary gland. Autonomic means sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve supply to the salivary gland. So regulation of the salivary secretion, first one simple or unconditioned reflex, where the stimulus is the presence of food in the mouth. Receptors, these are the taste buds. Afferent nerves from the taste buds carry impulses to the salivary center via the 9th cranial nerve, which is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Center, the salivary center, which is located in the medulla oblongata. And efferent via the autonomic nervous system supplying to the salivary gland, which includes the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Second one, conditioned reflex. It's an acquired reflex and needs training. The center is in the cerebral cortex. The reflex is activated on the sight, smell, thought of the food. In the absence of food in the mouth, increase the salivary secretion. So in this conditioned reflex, whenever we are going to see some of the food substances or we smell the food substances or any thought of the food inside our mind, it will initiate the salivary secretion. But here in this reflex of the conditioned reflex, there is not presence of food substance inside your mouth. So that is the conditioned reflex. Salivary secretions are regulated by nervous mechanisms only. Parasympathetic stimulation produces flow of watery saliva that is rich in enzymes. And sympathetic stimulation produces a much smaller volume of thick saliva that is rich in mucus. So here the parasympathetic stimulation produces flow of watery saliva that is rich in enzymes. And sympathetic stimulation produces much smaller volume of thick saliva that is rich in mucus. So here it is the flow chart. So first of all we are going to see the simple reflex or unconditioned reflex. Afferent, pressure receptors and chemoreceptor inside the mouth, these are the taste receptor. goes to the salivary center via the 9th cranial nerve, which is known as glossopharyngeal nerve. The afferent goes to the salivary center into the medulla, and efferent coming towards the salivary gland via the autonomic nerve, which include both the sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve system. So autonomic nerve, they supply to the salivary gland, there will be the increase in the salivary secretion. So this simple reflex or unconditioned reflex is initiated when we put some food particle inside our mouth. Now the conditioned reflex. How the conditioned reflex is initiated? Any smell, sight or thought of the food. So here the smell, sight and thought of the food are the inputs, and it is reacted by the cerebral cortex. It is processed in the cerebral cortex, and efferent goes to the salivary centers into the medulla oblongata, and the major efferents via autonomic nerve, it innervates the salivary gland, and there will be the increase in the secretion of the saliva. So that is the conditioned reflex without presence of food or in the absence of food inside the mouth. So here it is the conditioned reflex, and this one it is the unconditioned reflex, all right, or simple reflex.